The Changtang is a rolling upland that stretches across the northern part of the Tibetan Plateau. It's one of the least known places on Earth, a sweeping wilderness 16,000 feet high, punctuated with glacial peaks.
Beautiful. The males have black faces, a light tan coat, and horns that rise straight up for 2 feet. They weigh about 90 pounds, as compared to the females, which weigh around 60 pounds and are hornless. China has made them a mascot for the 2008 Olympics. But Chiru have one disadvantage. They have the finest wool in the world. During the late 1980s and 1990s, they were mass slaughtered by poachers who sold the wool to India to make chartreuse shawls for the world's luxury market.
Mm-hmm. 너만 무기하는 거지네.
做些申请的，那是不嘛的，说这个了嘛的，原来。在广东嘛的，实际嘛都说这个了嘛的，那是不购买这个了嘛的，不个最近通天怎么没这个了嘛的？在广东嘛，苏州嘛，哦，北京什么没到看嘛的？在广东嘛的，看到了做的，谁家看他们去了嘞？做啥的看到了？干些么子了嘞？东啥的看到了？谁家看他们去个小包运到先？但你在广东个这些的。
能给他的中国人靠个开销，包括农巴的那最后的，他没把中专们的手里做的，实际没得手里，对嘞？对，印度，他哦，这做个，这做在广东国家咋个去的？在这个没的，请个财政部去呢，请个没些那单独个单呢，请个个工人这个里，对哪里的？对你对没那广东国家咋个开的？对苏国，对咱们党国家个军情钱，对实际工人们他们这个这些讲的要求的。
The story of Chatouche is extraordinary. It's a very sort of long and fairly complex or tumultuous history over the last few years, because nobody ever really knew what the source of Chatouche was. And when I think it was in the early 90s, when Dr. George Schaller was working on the Tibetan Plateau, he found tens of thousands of chiru, or Tibetan antelope, being slaughtered there for their wool. Every single Chatouche shawl is made out of wool taken from a dead animal.
Let me show you this. These are, you've probably seen these, obviously, before.
That's the time I'm not talking to this.
From Tibet. These were given to us by the Chinese government to help us to educate people about the Chatouche trade. And they had been seized from poachers in Tibet.
You know, I know as a woman, in those days there was really nothing comparable to a Chatouche shawl. It's incredibly light, it's almost sort of feather light and very, very warm. And it falls beautifully. So it was always included as a part of the dowry, and if you were wealthy, you would have a few chatouche in your cupboard.
You see this one. This is an interesting one. This is a big one.
That
has been made in that Czech design specifically to appeal to the Western market. It's very easy for people here to think, well, endangered species live in other countries, therefore that's where the endangered species trade must be. And what we want them to understand is that, well, there's actually an endangered species trade here too. It's all illegal. And as long as we keep on buying things like chatouche, made from endangered species, then people in it, then other countries will lose their wildlife. And endangered species will be threatened with extinction. So all we've got to do is just stop buying it.
What do you feel they use it for, these large sizes?
Well, I don't know, but I suppose it could be a kind of a complete sleeping garment or something like that. That I don't know whether you could make a sari out of it if you were Indian. But basically, it's chatouche cloth, which perhaps you could make something out of for yourself, if you wanted to. The endangered species trade is like any other business. It's supply and demand. If we have demand coming from here, other people will supply it. So if we stop that demand, the whole thing will collapse.
One nomad told me, a rangeland without animals would not be a healthy one. In such grassroots effort lie the future of conservation, not just on the Tibetan plateau, but everywhere.
Gork, gork, gork.